This is Mr. Grice for Algebra 1, Chapter 12.2, Notes. Today we are talking about multiplying and dividing rational expressions. Our learning target today is to be able to simplify rational expressions that involve multiplying or dividing. Oh, hold on a second, this is freezing up. Okay, we're all good. Anyways, so the steps for multiplying rational expressions that have polynomials. One is to factor each numerator and denominator if possible, and then two, follow the rules of canceling. Now, let's review. Simplify the following expressions involving monomials. What we've talked about in the past is we multiply the top and multiply the bottom, and then we reduce, okay? So let's go ahead and do that. When you multiply the top, what do you get? Well, 3 times 6 is 18, x squared, y to the fourth. Now, on the bottom, 3 times 2 gives us 6, x cubed, y. And now let's look at each piece individually. 18 divided by 6. Well, 18 divided by 6, that's 3. Okay, look at your x's. Who wins, the top or the bottom? All right, well, the bottom wins, and the bottom wins by 1. What about the y's? Who wins, the top or the bottom? Okay, the top wins, and the top wins by 3. So there you go. That's what we get when we reduce. All right, number 2. Remember, we want to multiply the top and then multiply the bottom. So when you multiply the top, you get negative 24, a to the 7th, b to the, remember there's one right there, 3. Okay, 5 times 2 is 10, a to the 13th. Okay, and now we're going to do the same thing. First, we need to reduce negative 24 over 10. You can divide both of those by 2 and get negative 12 over 5. Who wins with the a's, the top or the bottom? Well, the bottom wins by 6, and we only have b to the third. And so we get negative 12b cubed over 5a to the 6th power. Okay? Now, what we're going to be doing with these ones is we want to simplify first. We need to factor each thing. Okay? So, let's take a look at what we got here. We've got 5x plus 10, and we can simplify that. So, 5x plus 10. Okay? You can take out the GCF of 5. And you're left with x plus 2. So when we start to simplify this, oh, hold on a second. Everything stays in the same position, 5, and we got x plus 2. Okay. Well, we can't do anything with x minus 3, so that's going to stay the same. Oh, that equals Mr. Grice times. Okay. And now, let's simplify the x squared minus 9. So we got x squared minus 9. And we can take the square root of both of those because it's the difference of two squares. And then I'm just going to write my answer up here. X plus 3, x minus 3. All right, and then we still have the 5. So you can kind of see where everything went. Now, what I want to do is I want to find things that are exactly the same, okay? My 5 and my 5, those can cancel out. And my x minus 3 and my x minus 3. So then what we're left with is x plus 2, x plus 3. And that's our final answer. Number four. Anytime you see something like this, we always want to put it over 1 because we're multiplying fractions. So we need it to be a fraction. So the first thing I can simplify is right there. So we're simplifying 2x plus 4. And we can take out a GCF of 2, and we're left with x plus 2. So we have x up top, and then right down here, we have 2x plus 2 times. Well, we've got a 1, and then we need to factor x squared plus 2x. So x squared plus 2x, we can factor out an x, and we're left with x plus 2. Now, do you guys see anything that is 100% the same? Well, I see the x plus 2s. Those cancel out. And then when you multiply x times x, that's x squared. And 2 times 1 is 2. Alright, number 5. Number 5, we have two different things that we need to simplify. Okay? We have the x squared minus 25, and then we have the x squared plus 6x plus 5. So I'm just going to kind of set this up so I know where I'm going to put all that new information. Here's where I'm going to factor them. And then the 12 and the 36, those stay there. So x squared minus 25, and then x squared plus 6x plus 5. This is the difference of two squares. So we take the square root of both, and we get x plus 5, x minus 5. Now, we need to split the middle term, the factors of 5. There's only 2, and it's 1 and 5. They're both positive. Okay? And now, we're going to do the box method over here. Just because we can get our binomial right away. But if you guys want to split the middle term and take out the GCF, technically you can do that too. Okay? Over here, the GCF of the top is x. Of the bottom, it's a positive 5. The left column, it's an x. And then the right column, it is positive 1. So when you're done with that, you should get x plus 5. X plus 1. And there we go. And so once again, now we start looking for things that are 100% exactly the same. And that's the x plus 5 and the x plus 5, so those cancel out. And now we're left with 12 and 36. And that actually reduces, okay? 36 divided by 12 is 3. So we have 3 on the top. X minus 5, and then don't forget the x plus 1. And since that's the only thing on the bottom, we don't need to have parentheses around it. Okay? Alright, now, let's look at the other side. Now we're going to talk about dividing rational expressions. Now, the first step is to change by multiplying by the reciprocal. And you might be like, well, Mr. Grice, why do we have to multiply by the reciprocal? Okay, well, let's talk about something. When we've got the fraction 2/3 times, let's just go 1/2. Okay, when you multiply that, 2 times 1 gives us 2, and 3 times 2 gives us 6. Okay, and we can reduce that to 1/3. Okay, But now, if we change that to dividing, I can't just multiply because I'd get the same answer. So what we have to do is multiply by the reciprocal, and we flip it around. 2 times 2 gives us 4, and 3 times 1 gives us 3. So if you can see, we have two completely different answers, and we should. We shouldn't get the same thing. Okay? So we're gonna flip the second fraction, and then the rest of the steps are just the same as what we did on the other side. Okay? So when we're doing this, I always want to make sure, hey, we're talking about division right here. So then we need to flip. So then it's 4a squared b cubed over b. The first fraction always stays the same. We're changing it to multiplication. The b goes on top, and the 3 goes on the bottom. Okay? And now it's the same. You have 4a squared b to the fourth because that's 1b, and then 3ab. And then our final answer, 4 and the 3, those stay. We have more a's on top, and we have more b's on top. We have division, so we need to flip. The first one stays the same. 3m11 8 9m. Why don't you guys pause the video and see if you can finish this one out all by yourself? Good luck. Okay, and there you go. 2 times 3 is 6, m11 and 7 on the bottom, 8m and 9. We reduce 6 and 8. The top wins for the m's, and the bottom wins for the n's. Okay, and that's all a review from chapter 6. So, simplify the following expressions involving monomials. We have division, so that means we need to flip. My first fraction stays the same. And now 6x squared goes on the bottom and 3x minus 6 on the top. So we need to figure out which ones we can reduce. And we can reduce the 2x squared plus 4x. So there's one that we're going to reduce. And then we can also reduce the 3x minus 6. Okay, so let's see, 2x squared minus 4x. We can take out a GCF of 2x. And what's left over is x minus 2. Over here we have 3x minus 6. We can plot a 3, and then we're left with x minus 2. So the things we changed was this guy up here and down there. So we have x squared, 3x minus 2, 2x, x minus 2, and 6x squared. Now, the things that we can cancel out are the x minus 2 and the x minus 2. Something else that you could see right away are the x squareds can cancel out. But then we get on the top 3, 2 times 6 is 12x. Well, we can reduce that to 1/4 x. Okay, because you can divide the top and the bottom by 3. Okay, remember that anytime you see that, we go over 1, we are dividing, So we need to flip. So we get x squared plus 2x, x minus 1 times, and after we flip it, the 1 goes on top, and we get x squared plus 2x. Now, a lot of you might be like, yo, Mr. Geis, can't we just cancel those out right away? Like, yes and no. Just because there might be other things that cancel out too, I think it's a good idea that we factor them anyways, just so we get used to that. Okay? So this comes up here. The purple one is going to go right here. And so we get x squared plus 2x. X squared plus 2x. We can pull out an x. And we get x plus 2. Same thing, we pull out an x, and we're left with x plus 2. Wow, that looks like chicken scratch. Let's rewrite that. There we go. So, well, we can cancel out the x plus 2 and the x plus 2. Cancel out the x's, but there's nothing else that cancel out. So it's always good just to double check that. And then we're left with 1. X minus 1. Okay? Alright, number 5. Okay, it's division, so we need to flip. X squared minus 25, we got x squared minus 49. Switch it to times. And then 2x minus 14, and then on the bottom is 5x plus 25. So we have a lot of things that we can reduce here. Okay, let's see, we've got 1 that we're going to reduce. We've got another one right there that we're going to reduce. Let's see, we've got the 2x minus 14 that we can reduce. So the key thing is when you're doing all this reducing, make sure that you've got a place to show all of your work. Okay? So, x squared minus 25. We get x plus 5, x minus 5. So x plus 5, x minus 5. Then we get the x squared minus 49. Well, once again, difference of two squares. X plus 7, x minus 7. Two x minus 14, we can take out a 2. And we're left with x minus 7. And then the 5x plus 25, we can factor out a 5, and we get x plus 5. Okay, now we're looking for things that are 100% exactly the same. I've got an x plus 5 and an x plus 5, and then an x minus 7 and an x minus 7. And then what's left on the top is 2. X minus 5, and on the bottom is a 5, x plus 7. And that's it. Okay. Now, if you want to try 6, you can go ahead and pause the video, and I will put the answer up in a second. Okay, well, there's the answer to number 6, and I did forget on the other side, there's also problem 6 over here, so if you'd like to try that one too, go ahead and pause the video. Okay, and you should get 1/2. Well, guys, that's it for Algebra 1, Chapter 12.2 Notes. If you have any questions, please come see Ms. Kranz or myself. Otherwise, this is Mr. Greis. Mr. Greis. Saying thanks for watching.